In this video, we're going to look at the different ways to make work planes within Vasari. I've started a new project and exited the initial mass so everyone can see how you create a mass and make sure that it's clear that you have to be inside of a mass to do these things. So we'll click the Create Mass button, and that's going to make the background light to let us know that we're in a mass. And let's go ahead and start by making a reference point. And so we'll click the point here. And you'll notice that it wants to set the plane that we're drawing on initially, and that's fine. We'll cover that in a bit. But we'll just click that and make our first point, and then I'll hit Escape twice on my keyboard to end the point command. And now let's select this point and come over to our Properties dialog box, and under Graphics, where it says Show Reference, let's say Always. Now we can see the different planes that exist on a point. All right, so to make these clear, let's draw some things on there. I'll click the model lines and I'll make a rectangle. And by default, the XYZ of the plane is selected because it was the last thing I had selected in the viewport. Now, if I want to specify a different plane, I can click the Set button and explicitly define a new plane on this point. And I'll draw another rectangle. And then I'll hit Escape on my keyboard to cancel that. And you can see that these lines are hosted on this point. If I move the point, those lines go with it because they essentially live on that point. They have a relationship to the planes on that point. And you can define any plane on the point as your current drawing plane. You can also tab over it and pre-select it, which implicitly defines it as your current work plane. So if I just tab over and select the horizontal one, you see that it turns blue to set it as my work plane. And it turns blue because I have this Show button clicked. That's a toggle to show you what your current work plane is. So let's go ahead and select these and get rid of them. All right, the next one we want to look at is a reference line. If we come over to our modeling tab and click reference, now we can draw a reference line. Before we draw it though, let's set our plane, because right now it just has the history of our point, which is gone. So I kind of want to try to be a little cleaner with my modeling than just drawing on top of that. So placement plane, I'll click level 1, and now that activates this as our current drawing plane. And let's click and draw our line and hit Escape. Now we've got a reference line. If I click it, you can see that it's got a few planes built into it. It's got a horizontal one, a vertical one, and the two ends. If I click Set, I can hover over the line and click Tab on my keyboard, and that'll cycle through my different possible work planes on that line. Once that's set, I can draw on there. We'll use a circle this time to change it up a little bit. Then I'll hit Escape on my keyboard. And you can see that that line is hosted on the reference line. So this is one of the major benefits of a reference line right here, is that it has a start and an end point. So later on when we want to do some pivoting with parameters or rotations, reference lines are a really good option for that because they have a start and an end. We can also host things on the beginning and the end of a reference line. So if I click Set again, click that, that's been hosted on the end of the reference line. All right, so let's select that and get rid of that. And those are reference lines. Next in the hierarchy is a reference plane. And those are in there by default in the massing environment. That's these dotted purple lines. All right, so if we click Set and click one of those, that sets it as our current drawing plane. We can also make our own by clicking the Plane button. It's going to ask us what plane we want to set it on, so I'm going to draw it on level 1. Now here I'll click and draw, and that sets a new reference plane. I'll hit the Escape key on my keyboard, and now if I hover, you can see that it's intersecting with our levels. And if I select it, it activates. I can also extend it, and this is just for visual reference, because it's not really geometry, it's a construction plane. And now with it selected, if I click to draw a new line, it implicitly defines it as our new drawing plane, which is really nice to be able to kind of quickly and fluidly continue to work. Now this geometry is hosted by that reference plane. If my plane moves, my lines move. Next in the hierarchy are levels. And if we're going to click and start drawing, we can set our level by picking it, or we can pick it from a drop-down list in our submenu here. So I can say I'm going to draw on level 5, and that sets it as our current drawing level. Now any geometry that I place on here is hosted by that level. If that level changes in elevation, that line would move with it. And these are all techniques we'll use down the road when we start to build up some more complex geometries. But you can mix and match any of these combinations. Points can be hosted on levels. Points can be hosted on lines. Lines, reference lines, can be hosted on reference planes. And through this combination of hosting of reference planes, you can start to build some pretty complex parametric models. So hopefully that gives you a foundation for reference planes. In the following videos, we'll look at some more advanced modeling techniques.